In the 1910s and 20s, the Great Plains were turned into farmland, plowing up several million acres of prairie land due to a mixture of unseasonably well farming conditions and the government allowing for cheap land out west. Though, with prices falling due to the Great Depression, the wheat market was failing. This led to farmers pulling up more prairie land in order to get more soil to grow their wheat. Instead of repurposing the soil so that it could act as an anchor, the Dust Bowl happened because of poor and wasteful farming. The soil had no prairie grass to anchor onto, and the wheat had shriveled in the droughts that hit the Great Plains in the 1930s. The winds made the dust swirl into large storms.
During the Dirty 30s, a plague of severe dust storms wreaked havoc along the farms. Millions of people left their farms, many heading to other states. Dust would clog the sky, kill crops and cattle, and spread dust pneumonia, which clogged up the lungs and killed hundreds. In time, the area where the storms affect became known as the Dust Bowl, after Black Sunday, a particularly bad storm on April 14, 1935.
Clouds of dirt shrouded the area, making an artificial night, causing damage that would last for months. To make matters worse, this was following another slew of dust.
We as a nation have three techniques that could possibly eliminate or downplay the effects of a Dust Bowl. Those three techniques are widespread irrigation, like drip irrigation and micro-sprinklers, that have been adopted by a majority of commercial farmers, leaving crop residue on the fields to cover the soil to promote the growth of new plants, and planting trees to reduce the amount of wind on the crops, which is known as windbreaks. Terraces also hold back water and route it along a channel at a lower velocity to where it can be safely discharged. Ultimately, our new farming methods will reduce the effects of a major drought and will hopefully not lead to another Dust Bowl.
During President Franklin D. Roosevelt's first 100 days in office in 1933, he quickly initiated programs to conserve soil and restore the ecological balance of the nation. Interior Secretary Harold L. Ickes established the Soil Erosion Service in August 1933 under Hugh Hamid Bennett. In 1935, it was transferred and reorganized under the Department of Agriculture and renamed Soil Conservation Service. It is now known as the Natural Resources Conservation Service. As part of the New Deal programs, Congress passed the Soil Conservation and Domestic Allotment Act, requiring landowners to share government subsidies with the laborers that worked on their farms.